The descent into the abyss in Haiti is fastest here. The one certainty is when the police SWAT team we are with cross into gang territory, they will take fire. It is now a blunt war for control of the capital. The police need to prove they can be here, the gangs that the police cannot. And it is ordinary citizens who are caught in between. Here, a passenger on a civilian bus that was hit in the street. In the days before, police said they've rescued 6 hostages in this same area and killed a leader of the 400 Mawozo gang. But the police struggle to hold ground, so the gangs, whose currency is kidnapping and drugs, are gaining far too much. Especially right here. Rounds hit the armored vehicle. They think they see where the gunmen are. They run, but not like it's their first time under fire, perhaps even this day. They slide back. Perhaps the gang have fled down the alley.
It's this kind of intense violence that so many cite when they talk about Haiti's spiral towards collapse.
The firepower they bring doesn't in itself change who's in control. Gangs are able to block main roads at will with trucks. And it requires a major operation to clear them. Gangs now often match or outgun the police. They have a bulldozer too, demolishing rivals' houses in one area, Cité Soleil. Locals fled at night during 10 days of clashes in July that left over 470 dead, injured or missing, said the UN, as the G9 gang expanded control, burning and demolishing. Those who survived fled to nights here, where a mix of flies and rain stopped them from even sleeping. To see where acute desperation can lead, we travel to where what's left of the government rarely treads. Don't be fooled by the beauty. There is no paradise here. Only hunger, heat, trash, and the business of leaving. Traffickers' boats out to the Bahamas, Cuba, Florida if you're lucky. And while these places are sending Haitians back in record numbers, the US Coast Guard is also stopping 4 times as many this year as last. These exits are what Johnny arranges.
If we die, we die. If we make it, we make it. I'm the one who buys the boat. It can cost up to $15,000. We are hoping to get 250 people for the next trip because the boat is big.
Not everyone made it on their last trip 3 months ago.
The boat had an engine problem. Water got inside the boat. We called for help, but it took too long. 29 people died on that trip.
These aren't people who usually share their trade secrets, but maybe now they're relaxed as the authorities are busy. The boat is aging, scraps of net plugging holes, engines not fixed yet. But this is where Johnny hopes 250 people will huddle, maybe as early as next week.
I mean, not really something you want to be in on dry land, let alone out at sea, for days.
One man tells us why he saved for a year to get into here.
After études classiques, moi rentré dans faculté.
I graduated and worked as a teacher, he says, but it did not work out. Now I am driving a motorcycle every day in the sun and the dust. How will I be able to take care of my family when I have one? I'm not afraid. I will be eaten by a shark or make it to America. A hope so remote, it could only exist here, where they say the choice is between fire and water, even if all day, every day, already feels like drowning.